I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Winterhaven. I'm Myla, and you're watching BDTV for Tuesday, April 4th, 2023. Coming up on today's show is nutrition and Quicksilver. I can tell you all about it.
And I'm Materia.
Let's get into the announcements.
Students, remember to check your email every day. You may receive testing information and other important news through your school email.
The April Scholarship Bulletin is out. If you have any questions, see Ms. Bachman.
Seniors, you are to report all offers of scholarships to Mrs. Bachman, even if you don't accept them. This is a district requirement.
There will be a senior meeting April 13th in the auditorium, third block, where your cap and gown will be distributed.
Cap and gown orders have late fees of $20 beginning today. In order to walk the stage at graduation, you must have a cap and gown. See Mrs. Bachman for information.
I bet seniors know about nutrition.
Here at Winterhaven, all of our students have the opportunity to eat two free meals every single day. This is important for our nutrition. I'm Myla with BTV. Let's go learn more about nutrition. Why is it important for students to eat breakfast every day?
So it's one of those things as you're coming to school, you want to make certain that you have the nutrients and you have the energy so when you get into class that you're ready to keep going. If you don't have breakfast and you get there, you're not going to have the energy to be able to think and to be able to do the work that you need to be able to do. So it's important.
How much of your daily plate should be whole grains?
1/4.
How much of your daily plate should be fruits?
1/4.
How much of your daily plate should be vegetables?
I think 1/4.
How much of your daily plate should be protein?
1/4.
What is your favorite part about eating school lunch?
Oh, so my favorite part about eating school lunch would probably be, you know, trying the different things that they have every day because they have like a big schedule for the month where they have a different type of food every day. And, you know, they always have the chicken sandwiches, but like they have empanadas, they have nachos. And, you know, me and my friend Myla like to go on TikTok and try all the different foods that they have.
Eating breakfast every day is important for fueling your body and gaining energy. And eating lunch sustains this energy. I'm Myla with BDTV. See you at lunch.
I bet the boys' volleyball team eats really healthy.
For sure. The boys' volleyball team is 6-0. Their next game will be tonight at 7 here in the gym. Be sure to come out and support our Blue Devils.
Are you interested in hosting a Dutch student in October? Do you want to travel to the Netherlands for spring break next year? If so, use this QR code to fill out an application.
Hey, Tyria, did you have fun at prom?
Yeah.
Well, special thanks to Ms. McCalla and Ms. Archambault for helping this year's prom happen.
I wonder who won the senior notables.
Serenity Hardy for being Lakeland's Ledger's Girls Basketball Player of the Year. Congratulations to Briasia Washington for making the All-County First Team, and to Jaden Williams and Quinaya Sanders for making second team.
Our Blue Devil track and field team went to Lake Mineola to compete in the Hawks on the Hill invite against 26 teams this past weekend. The boys placed 8th overall, and the major contributions go to Donis Brimmer, who placed 3rd in the 400 and 4th in the long jump. The girls placed 3rd overall with a string performance from Dejanique Henry, who won the long jump, 200 meters and the 400 meters, breaking her own school record. An overall superb performance from everyone. The county championship is set for Saturday, April 8th at George Jenkins. Come out and support.
If you're interested in joining the yearbook staff next year, see Dr. Jaime in room 35222 for an application.
I bet the yearbook staff loves Quicksilver.
Quicksilver, what's up with your goofy haircut?
Hey, no more questions. So you see that fight right there? I want you to film it. Make sure you're recording. I gotta look good for my viewers, okay? That's all I have for you today, Winter Haven. Make sure you stay in class. I'm Quicksilver, and I got a dash. All right, thank you. So same time next Tuesday. All right. Tickets are $97, and what are you doing?
Quicksilver, you've been acting so strange lately. You only care about what other people think of you and your self-image. Listen, bud, the other day I saw you stop a fight, but then I saw you make sure that they were filming you. And then that same day, I saw you take money from someone for a commercial. Is that all this is about? Money? This isn't the Quicksilver we know and love.
Hey, can you start filming again? All right, I gotta address the public. Guys, I'm sorry. I haven't been who I've meant to be. I've become so cocky and I forgot about my own.
I know Quicksilver has a lot of school spirit, and so do our teachers. The next Teacher Spirit Day will be Thursday, April 6th, and the theme is Decades. I hope to see you all decked out. Any students interested in getting community service hours, volunteers are needed for Hoops Haven spring and summer basketball camps and clinics.
There will be a blood drive tomorrow, April 5th. Today is the last day to sign up during your lunch period.
That's all we have for you today, Winter Haven. I'm Milo with BDTV. Have a great day.
To our boys basketball team. Coach Woodside is Coach of the Year and Isaac Salazar is Player of the Year. And all of our starting lineup made the Ledger's All-County Team segment. Let's start with our Player of the Year. Isaac Salazar, 3-4, can provide the team with whatever is needed. He averaged almost 16 points per game, 9 rebounds per game, 3.9 assists per game, 1.7 scores per game. Isaac was MVP of 2 tournaments this season. Congratulations, Isaac. Now under Coach Woodside, he led Auburn Rebels for a 27-5 season and played one of the most difficult schedules in the state. Winter Haven won district and regional titles and came within one possession of being state champions. Congratulations to Dylan James and KJ Parker, who are on the Ledger's All-County First Team. Now under Dylan James, who is our senior center. He averaged 12.8 points per game, 9.2 rebounds per game, 1.9 assists per game, and now KJ Parker, who is our senior guard. He averaged 14.8 points per game, 4.7 rebounds per game, 2.8 assists per game, and 1.2 steals per game.